The revolution's near, but to me it seems quite clear that it's all just a little bit of history repeating. That it's all just a little bit of history repeating.
Maryland and North Carolina State trying to carve out their own piece of history today in advance to the championship game in the ACC. They bear the same colors, strive for the same result, a championship in Greensboro, and then a shot at further glory in the NCAA tournament. It's presented by 7-Up, all part of Championship Week, as Maryland takes on North Carolina State in the ACC semifinals from Greensboro, North Carolina. Duke has already advanced to its sixth consecutive championship game, knocking off Georgia Tech on the strength of a brilliant second half against the Yellow Jackets. We'll be back with the tip to see who makes it to the finals tomorrow in just a moment.
ESPN's exclusive presentation of Championship Week is presented by 7-Up and your local 7-Up bottler. Make 7-Up yours. And in part by Mazda. There's a soul of a sports car in everything we make.
Back in Greensboro for the ACC semifinals, Maryland, North Carolina State, a sellout crowd of 24,000 on hand to see this one. Dick, let's take a look at our star watch.
Well, we talk about some stars in this game. Should feature some really outstanding people. Tanner Medley's a guy that really had a big game against Wake. 13 points, and Marcus Melvin came up big with 16 points and 8 rebounds. He's an inside-outside threat. I think also what makes North Carolina State so dangerous is the fact that they're so effective on a free throw line. They're shooting, you ready for this? 79.9% as a team for the entire year on the free throw line.
Here's the downside for North Carolina State tonight. Scooter Sherrill, one of their great seniors, will be unable to play the entire tournament even if they advance. And Jordan Collins, one of the big guys, hurt his knee yesterday. Barring a miracle, he is not going to play today. Let's go to Mark Jones and find out more.
Yeah, guys, Jordan Collins underwent treatment since the time he suffered the injury yesterday in the Florida State game. He came out here this morning, tried to see what kind of lateral movement he had. Frankly, the coaches said he didn't have any, so the chances are, I'm told, that he will not play today. The dilemma that faces NC State with now is that they have only 9 bodies, 7 players of which get quote-unquote real minutes or real playing time. Back to you.
And that will be a problem against a team as deep as Maryland, because Maryland can run waves of players at you.
Well, there's Scooter Sherrill. You take a look. He went right over that left ankle.
He tore a muscle in his ankle. He would not be available even if they make it till tomorrow. They're hoping he will be able to come back and play in the NCAA tournament.
North Carolina State's had one heck of a year, though, Mike, to finish second in the ACC. Herb Sendek's been able to quiet down some of the critics. 3 times he's been in the final game of the ACC tournament.
And he has got to be the choice for the coach of the year. And Gary Williams has done one of his better coaching jobs in the 15th season in College Park, because he has such a young team. Nobody lost more talent than he did. And Herb Sendek hoping to advance to a third straight championship game. Runs that Princeton type offense, and they are so tough to play.
They really are. They create so many problems. This game comes down to tempo, comes down to the pace of the game. Maryland obviously wants to go up and down at a full, quick pace. On the other side, they're going to lull you to sleep a little bit and then try to get a backdoor cut or an open three out of their, as you said, Princeton offense.
Heftemoff chases down the opening tip. One of the keys to watch for, Maryland shot the ball so well yesterday. That has rarely been the case this season. If they shoot well, they're an extremely dangerous team.
Well, Gilchrist was 4-for-4 from the trifecta. Had a big performance. Here's the guy, Mr. Versatility, Julius Hodge.
Hodge kicks it outside. Melvin, great range, short on his first 3. And Nick Tanner Medley grabs the rebound for Maryland.
You're right. This is a very young and talented team, Maryland. earlier in the year, beat Wisconsin, beat Florida when they were number one in the nation down there with the Rowdy Reptiles.
Smith, who had been missing in action lately, played very well yesterday. And Garrison fires up a brick.
That was Brick City, USA.
Melvin backing in. Double team, Kaner Medley loves to come from the weak side and go for blocks. And that time, Gilchrist, with good anticipation, made the steal.
He's one of the young stars in the league at the point guard slot. Just like a guy like Jarrett Jacks, got better and better this year, got a lot of minutes. Stepping in for Steve Blake, who's now in the NBA.
Gilchrist, an extremely strong guard.
Yeah, very physical, very tough, good upper body.
Smith powers his way in, missed a shot, got his own rebound. Follow will not go, just hung on the rim and dropped off.
They won such a tough game yesterday against Wake Forest. Chris Paul had 30 in that game.
Atsuer, the freshman, they'll need him today in this outside shooting.
Eftimov, so solid player, can pass the ball exceptionally well.
Atsuer, for three.
Atsuer from out of Turkey has really improved as the season's progressed. He's had some big, big moments.
The other guy to watch is Cameron Bennerman, number 13 for NC State. He's in there because of the injuries, starting only his second and third game of his career. And Garrison off the little pass, missed his shot, got his own rebound, missed again.
Bennerman's been a big story at 16, a career high against Wake Forest, and came back and got 17 yesterday.
Eftimov, another good outside shooter, buries the three at 6-0.
He can flat out shoot the basketball. He is automatic at the free throw line. I mean, he's challenging now for a school record of Rodney Monroe.
Maryland has missed its first five shots. Nearly a turnover there, saved by McCray. Terps looking a little tight right now as they start this game. Garrison left alone. He's a street shooter. Eftimov going for a rebound, and Eftimov will be called for the foul. It's a very young, very athletic Maryland team led by Gilchrist, the point guard, who was outstanding last night, 16.6 assists. Kaner Medley, probably their most consistent shooter and a very good outside shooter.
And Smith, really effective inside. There he is with the left hand. Very quick, active player. Hey, Eftimov has 38 in a row at the free throw line. He only needs six more to break the record of Rodney Monroe, who hooked up with Mr. Corciani's in the house, was honored with the legends here.
Had a chance to talk to Chris a little bit earlier. Always great to see him. Melvin missed on the drive, but Hodge is there to clean it up.
There's the kid from out of New York City. Played at St. Raymond's, out of the Bronx, an outstanding all-around player.
Nice tip pass there by McCray. Kaner Medley works his way in, and Maryland getting some great looks, can't hit anything. 1-for-8 in the first 3.5 minutes.
Both these clubs split. There's the versatility of
Hodge. Got away from McCray. It looked like Maryland got away with a foul. Hodge gets it again. This time there will be a foul on Garrison.
I'll tell you, Hodge so effective that he can go inside, outside. And what a team they are in a free throw line. I mean, what an advantage that is to have when you shoot 79.9 as you look at that starting lineup with Bennerman in there instead of Sherrell.
Hodge, Melvin, and Eftimov. Melvin really their only big guy, the only rebounder, and he has the added benefit of being able to take the opposing center outside because of his great range.
You know, Bennerman replacing Sherrill. Think about this. He had 56 points in 26 games, and in the last two, he's had 33. Unbelievable. He's probably said, hey, coach, give me some PT. I could have done this all year. Where you been, coach?
Exactly. Hodge, who is in the top four in the ACC in free throw shooting, hits them both, and it's 10-2. Great start for the Wolfpack.
And they're really playing on the defensive end, as you see Hodge right there stepping into the passing lane, anticipating really well. He's missed the versatility in this league, and he's very confident player.
Akene Ibekwe will check in for Maryland, another one of those young players who plays great in streaks. He did not have a good game last night.
Beckway's one of those kids who has a great upside along with Fofana. They're going to get better and better.
Eftimov got the steal, then threw it right back to Gilchrist.
They're very active right now defensively, North Carolina State, really communicating.
And today's the day they have to stay out of foul trouble, Dick.
Yeah, really. You're right when you talk about their depth factor without Sherrill and without Collins.
Bennerman fadeaway jump shot. Oh, check it. That was Chris McCray. I'm looking at number 13 in red, and I'm thinking Bennerman.
You got the right number.
This Bennerman 13 with red and white. Smith with a steal. Melvin got it back to Hodge. Hodge kicks it to Eftimov. Got it.
Can't let him square that body, man. He's like a J.J. Redick kind of shooter. Out all of last year with the knee dilemma, had the knee surgery.
North Carolina State has hit three of its first four three-point shots. Smith. Beckway recovers, not a backcourt violation because it was touched. Maryland's tried two and not hit.
Trying to low screen and roll right here with Gilchrist and Smith.
Gilchrist finally got his way into the lane, kicks it out to a Beckway, and a Beckway hits the jump.
I love the potential of this kid. I mean, he's come out of nowhere, a kid that was not heavily big-time recruit, name-wise, in terms of a McDonald's All-American. We've seen flashes, but obviously he's been up and down, and that's going to happen with a young player.
And they have so many young players that one of Gary Williams' problems is who is going to play well in that particular game. Good feet inside to Hodge. Hodge has the shot blocked, but he's fouled.
They really spread the court really well and utilize a lot of good cuts, back cuts. Here's a look at Herb Sendick, was part of a great staff along with Tubby Smith, Billy Donovan. I mean, what a staff Rick Pitino assembled. That tells you a little bit about the guy that's the head guy that can recognize people like that. Can you imagine that as a staff? I mean, you're talking about Tubby Smith, you're talking about Herb Sendick, Billy Donovan as assistants, and Ralph Woolard. I mean, it's unbelievable.
Hodge is in the top 10 of so many ACC categories, it's almost impossible to list them, but he is the second leading scorer, seventh leading assist man, fourth leading free throw shooter. And you may have seen Hassan Fofana come into the ballgame for Maryland. He is number 44. And if you drew up a picture of how to put together an athlete and what he ought to look like when you're done, it's Hassan Fofana. That guy is 290. He looks like he's 240. Great start for State. Back in a moment. Back in Greensboro, North Carolina, and State with a nice early lead over Maryland, 15-6. The Wolfpack, with its best season in years in the ACC, finishing second to Duke in the regular season.
Well, one of the greatest games, as you know, in 74 in this tournament was really special. That was the year Maryland and North Carolina played one of the greatest games ever, 103-100 in overtime. Unbelievable.
Many people say it was the best college basketball game ever played, and a lot of people, maybe 200,000, will tell you they saw it in person. They didn't have a 200,000 arena at that time, did they? DJ Strawberry into the game, makes his presence known immediately, and wow. Here is Beckway with a steal.
4 points, Beckway a diaper dandy, Strawberry a diaper dandy. You mentioned that was a great, great game, and that was Norm Sloan, the late Norm Sloan, who won that game. Also back, when you think about UCLA, when they had a matchup with Lou Alcindor and Elvin Hayes was a special game.
Hodge, nice ball movement. Sure for three. Can't hit it. Eftimov tried to keep it alive, but couldn't. Fofana screened him off.
They're getting a little lift out of Strawberry. He gives him a little lift off that bench.
He played very well last night. Shot the ball well, which he has not done all year.
Yeah, it gives him some energy.
Fofana with a runner down the lane, halfway down, came out.
I'll tell you, Fofana is going to be a very good player. He's agile, he's mobile, and I'll tell you, he's not fragile.
He's 290 pounds. He moves like he's 210.
I'll tell you, this offense would drive me nuts trying to coach and defend against it. Spread the court, they invert people so well. It's tough to teach that, too. I mean, a lot of people say, well, why don't everybody teach that? It's tough to teach.
Atsur with a runner goes down hard. Levi Watkins is into the ball game for North Carolina State. He'll get more minutes today because of the injury to Jordan Collins.
Right down the lane. There's a look at their resume right now. 20 victories, second in the conference. RPI 12, schedule strength 7. You know, you've arrived as a program when other schools use you as a barometer and say, well, we beat North Carolina State.
That's right.
That means you've arrived now.
And their 11th wins in the conference were the best they've had since 1974.
This guy's automatic, man, and he misses it. Oh, 38 in a row.
Eftimov had gotten his average near the 90% mark, and that one rattles out. 38 straight. He's number two in the ACC.
Rodney Monroe's record stands now. 43 in a row. He's chasing it.
Well, we don't believe in jinxes, but mail.
Now, statistics caught up with a probability, man. Go back and take a stats class. They'll tell you eventually it's going to go that way.
It's like if you shoot free throws, eventually one of them's going to go in.
One's going to go in eventually. You're right. Stefanov trying to make good post presence inside. I really talked about in the first game what the ACC is going to be about. You better include Maryland in there as a terrific team next season.
John Gilchrist with an off-balance shot, and it's 16-13. Maryland coming back.
He was so brilliant in the second half against that Skip Prosser basketball team last night.
Eftimov fakes the three.
Hodge had 28 in a victory over Maryland at Maryland.
Melvin kicks it out to the corner. The three too strong. Here comes McCray. Tough shot. Wouldn't go, but he gets the foul.
McCray, a good athlete, gets out in transition.
Dick, you just saw the one missed free throw. Let's take you back in time a little bit to J.J. Redick's streak earlier this year.
Oh, we saw him this time.
Check this number out. I don't want to jinx the kid. Check that number in that line.
Yeah! Oh! Ends the streak.
54 in a row.
We're always accused of being jinxes. If I thought we had that much power, I would relish
exactly.
in it.
Exactly. What about all they make while we're there?
That's right.
Nobody talks about that. I tell you, our production team goes out and they get it. Look at that mug. Look at the reaction right there. He can't believe it. He said that can't happen.
Now, when you're that good, you just don't expect it anymore. McCray hits his first free throw and makes them both. And Maryland has crawled back to within a point.
Well, you know, Gary Williams, I think, has made some good moves coming off the bench with some subs that have brought back a little energy to this team. This team is really a different team here in the last 3 minutes.
And I tell you what, since the last week of the season, they have played intense basketball, and they have played very well together. And Gary, I talked to him at the beginning of the season, said, who knows, by the end of the year, we might be pretty good.
Well, they are pretty good. They're forced to turnover on a 9-1 run. You know, at the end of the year, they had some must games. They had to win a game at
NC State. One of them at NC State.
Exactly. They won by a point, then came back home, and they had to beat Virginia at home. Then last night, Gary felt they had to close it out by winning last night for an NCAA berth, even though I thought they would be in with 7 wins.
And they did that, too. Right now, they're back to within 1.
Welcome back, everyone, to the Greensboro Coliseum. Right now, Maryland trailing by a point against NC State. Let's take a look at Maryland's tournament resume, and who would have thought that at this time of the year they would be in this kind of position? Remember yesterday, Gary Williams cut me off. He says, emphatically, they are in the tournament. A very young Maryland team. Interesting that there were questions about where the leadership would come from. Well, one of the guys that's emerged as a leader is Gilchrist at point guard. He's constantly talking, even in practice. Yesterday in the game against Wake Forest, he was yapping at their bench a lot. But Gary Williams says, I love the way his leadership rolls off his tongue. And he says, we've got enough great guys on the team who are quiet. It's good to have John being John. Guys, you can't have enough Boy Scouts or too many Boy Scouts on the team.
Well, you know, it's not bad having Boy Scouts, but John wants to be a little bit like Gary. He says, hey, if Gary can talk, I can talk.
And he was exceptional against Wake Forest. And one thing about Gilchrist, he's got to play so many minutes because they don't have a true backup point guard.
You know, Maryland became a little bit more aggressive when Ebekwe came on in Strawberry. They forced 3 turnovers out of the 4 in the few minutes they were on the floor.
They can bring some athletes out there. Maryland with a chance to take the lead. if they can get a defensive stop here. And Etzer makes sure that's not going to happen.
They got so many weapons on that perimeter. They really do a great job spreading the court. That's part of an offensive system. Spread the court, get some good angles for cuts off the post, and also then have guys stationary out on the wings for jump shots.
North Carolina State, 4 out of 7 on three-point shots. What a tough shot by Gilchrist.
Is he feeling it? You know what I love about him? He has got a special winner's mentality. He's so tenacious.
Atsor against the trap, gets away from it.
I saw him down here against Florida when they were number one in America down in Gainesville. And I'm going to tell you, he didn't let the Roddy Reptiles bother him at all. He and Cater Medley played brilliantly.
Tough to press NC State. Everybody handles the ball well. Watkins got into the lane, scooped it, won't go. Eftimov
having a big afternoon. Watkins drove the drive, the gap. They really attacked the gap exceptionally well. Look at the points in the paint right now. Maryland with the big edge.
Eftimov already has 9, and State's back up by 4. Here comes the trap on Gilchrist.
That was a dangerous pass right there. That baby was ready to be picked off.
Nick Kaner Medley, who hasn't gotten in track yet. Abekwe lost it on the way in. Steal for NC State.
As soon as you turn your back on that dribble, you're susceptible to a guy rotating over and giving help.
Atsur to Eftimov.
They space those three-point shooters so well. Makes it tough for you to defend and give help.
Melvin probably not going to have much luck inside against the big guy, Fofana. By 7-Up continues with games on ESPN2. At 7, Kent State, Western Michigan in the MAC Championship. Then at 9, UTEP against Nevada for the WAC Championship.
Wow, if Kent State were to beat Western Michigan, that creates another nightmare for some teams in terms of an at-large berth. Western Michigan's had a great year. I think they deserve to be in no matter what. I'll tell you,
what
he's
a
on fire.
Three by Eftimov. He is really rolling, has a dozen already in 11 minutes.
He's on fire. His brother went to North Carolina before heading to Europe to play. All the North Carolina State faithful jump with joy. One of the tough parts of that job is you have to operate in the shadows of North Carolina and Duke. There he is spotting up with a little curl move.
3 out of 3 for Eftimov as Garrison was late getting out through the screen.
Looking for Fano inside now. There he is on the interior. Oh, he steps right on his foot.
I mean, this guy's immovable.
Yes, sir. Incredible. Hey, I'll tell you one thing. You think about what's happening in America. People don't think these tournament games are important. Just think what happened to Utah State and Southern Illinois and Air Force. And if it happens with Kent State over Western Michigan, that again drops down to the pecking order and eliminates teams like the Florida States and the Missouris.
Eftimov already with a dozen.
What a performance thus far. I mean, he's been incredible other than make this in a free throw where you think he's automatic.
24-17. NC State plays tough defense. They have all year long.
With a lot of help, a lot of communication, very active. The collapse on a ball inside, good zigzag, but now we can get it to
nice
the weak
pass
side.
By Garrison, and Smith finishes.
Great play by Garrison to spot the double up. As soon as the double up comes, you want to go to the opposite side of the floor because the defense flows to the basketball.
24-19. Melvin open for 3. He's got a great stroke.
He can do that. He can do that.
Julius Hodge is their leader and perhaps the best player in the conference, but I think Melvin's the most valuable player on this team. I don't think they can win without him.
What about Powell leaving so early? What a decision he made. Really not bright at all for that decision. I mean, he's playing in Europe somewhere where he could be on a collegiate level, being a star, improving his stock.
Atsor with a steal off the poor pass. NC State has hit 6 of its first 9 three-point shots.
That's pretty good shooting, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
That's two-thirds, man. That's third. 66%.
Knocked out of bounds. Terps can't save it. Good hustle. And Strawberry enjoying his trip down Press Lane. 7:58 to go, first half. Wolfpack back on top by 8. Come on.
Look at Strawberry's talking to everybody.
NC State has expanded its lead back to 8 points with 7:58 to go in the first half.
Watch how they're going to collapse defensively on the inside. They're going to collapse to the interior right here. Freeze it right here. There's the collapse. Now he's going to look opposite. As soon as you go opposite against the traps, you get a wide open shot right there by Smith. Good triple threat position and the drive. Excellent play from the post, bringing the ball out to Smith. Go opposite to the trap.
NC State so far shooting the ball exceptionally well, especially from long range. Hodge, Atzor, Beneman, Eftimoff, and Melvin for Herb Sendak.
Hodge is made to order for this system because he goes inside, outside, very active. Eftimoff, long three. Somebody better get in his face, man. Somebody better deny him the ball.
It's too late. He already has 15 points.
They better get in before he has 30.
He's already hit four straight from outside, and Beneman will pick up a foul against Gilchrist.
He's just spotting up at the three-point line. And they don't give a lot of help. Now watch this right here. So you can't give help. They're getting out a little bit late. I mean, he shot
that. He's on
the
bench.
He shot that from Raleigh, man. He shot that from Raleigh.
You know, biggest lead of the ball game right now, 11 points for NC State.
You know, as I said earlier, you play in the shadows of North Carolina, and Duke puts a lot of pressure on a coach at NC State. Jimmy V was able to handle that in mediocre years because he was so funny with all the one-liners. I mean, Herb Sendak, unfortunately, has to win big or the critics just come out like crazy.
McCray couldn't win. There aren't many critics this year.
There better not be. I tell you, those talk shows.
Had an exceptional season.
Take a look at this performance. The rest of the team, 15. Eftimoff getting an A-plus early in this game.
He's already graduated.
Yeah, he's got his doctorate, shooting the three. Doctor of hoopology.
Beneman, back-to-back career highs, can't hit the runner.
Yeah, Beneman really feeling. He's got a vertical jump of about 42 inches as well.
And he's having a great time because he played high school ball here in Greensboro. Nice steal by Hodge.
Yeah, played at Brinsley High School right here in Greensboro.
2-on-2, Beneman.
There's Beneman, he's at home, man. He didn't need a wake-up call again here. He was ready to play. They wrote about him today in the Greensboro News.
Julius Hodge is one of those guys who has worked to make himself a better player, and he has done it.
There's Julius Hodge handling the rock in transition. 6'6", very versatile. Beneman getting a chance to play. He's saying like, hey, Coach Sendak, where have you been all year? I could have been helping this team instead of sitting on the pine.
North Carolina State on a 16-3 run, and they're up by 13.
You know, kids like this, they end up looking at you as a coach. I've been here in that situation where you give them some minutes finally, and they play superbly. They look at you like you're a dummy, saying, Coach, where were you?
Well, exactly. This is only his third start of his career. He started against Wake Forest, had a career-high 16 points, got a start in the first game of the ACC tournament, had a career-high 17 points.
So that means today he gets 18. He goes up third career high.
And you're right. He probably slipped a note under Herb Sendek's door and said, Coach, look at what I'm doing. The injured players, Scooter Sherrill and Jordan Collins, on the bench.
Yeah, the reason he got a chance to start because of the injury to Scooter, to Sherrill.
What a shot by Smith, and he gets the foul as well.
He has really become a factor inside all year for them. Last year he played on a second club. Here he is now going to whirl inside. He's got great confidence of his quickness on the interior.
At one point this year, Dick, he was averaging well over a double-double. At 10.5 rebounds a game, his numbers have really fallen off in the second half of the season. But the last two or three games, he's shown the form that really gave everybody such optimism at the start.
Well, you know, their backs, again, to use that old cliche, were sitting here right against that wall, and they were forced to go to NC State and get a W.
Not a good free throw shooter. Looked pretty good on that one. And Maryland has shot the ball so poorly from the free throw line all year long. They could have four more victories easily if they had been a better free throw shooting team.
There's that versatility of Hodge looking right over the trap with the great size.
Beneman with the left hand.
Are you kidding me? How is this guy sitting on a bench all year, Mr. Patrick? Come
on,
Coach Patrick. I mean, unbelievable. I got to talk to Herb. What's going on? You got this guy's a ringer, man. Where'd he find this guy?
He looks like a seasoned veteran.
Where'd he get that dude? I don't understand that. They are in a little zone now. Matchup.
steal by Melvin. And Maryland is killing itself with four passes. That time, McCray, too strong. And right now they have Gilchrist out of there, and this has been the downfall for the Terps all year. When Gilchrist has to take a breather, they do not handle a ball well.
When I was last year with Blake, they didn't have confidence in the young kid, Gilchrist, coming in.
Great pass to Hodge, great head fake, and Hodge puts it in. And right now, NC State is just tearing the Terps apart.
I'll tell you, he's one of those rare players that you can invert. I really believe that Rashawn McCants is that kind of player as well and doesn't utilize it enough going inside and taking advantage of his ability on a low post.
Jones is in for Maryland. He's an outstanding shooter, another young man.
Julius Hodge, multi-dimensional. There's the entry from Atsur inside. Now watch the little fake right here. There's the little fake, keeps himself on the ground, it comes back up. No panic, he had poise right there. The poise led to points. PP.
Strawberry right now, guarded by Hodge. Try to go inside to Kaner Medley, knocked out of bounds off Kaner Medley, and it's out to NC State.
Strawberry from out of California. Everybody knows by now, Dad, Darryl Strawberry. Has a look at Betterman right now. Gonna see him explode to the basket. He's in the left hand, he's doing it all.
Terps have turned it over the last two possessions without Gilchrist in there to run the club.
Yeah, they miss it. No question he has to be on the floor. He's their floor leader.
Isn't that one of those deals, Dick, where he says, I'm tired, and you say, I'll tell you when you're tired? You can rest at the end of the day.
Rest at the end of the year when you start playing intramurals.
Exactly. 4:21 to go, first half. Hodge kicks it out. Watkins double team, forces the shot as the buzzer was coming and hit it anyway.
I'll tell you one thing, they're having one of those halves. What a clinic they're putting on in the first half. Everything going down.
Right now, NC State can do no wrong. They're up by 16. Jones, tough fadeaway shot. Melvin with a rebound.
They really look impressive right now. Watching them play, they've been the most impressive of any of the teams thus far. Other than that second half, Duke was very impressive in the second half.
They have hit eight of their last nine shots to assume a 16-point lead. This is a great front-running team, Dick, too. When they get ahead, they can work that clock like nobody.
Up and away, Julius Hodge, jamming Julius from out of the Big Apple, from out of New York City. He wants to be the player of the year in the ACC. He wants the MVP trophy. David, there it is, right down the lane, jam.
Nobody rotated over until it was too late.
There he goes, right to the goal.
Julius Hodge, five times this year, has led his teams in points, rebounds, and assists.
That's not bad. That's not bad.
Sounds like Magic Johnson, doesn't it?
Wow. He's got that strut now. Look at him. He's got that strut going to the sideline. Shoulders up, head up. He's got the little bounce, the little slide, the little glide.
A 25-7 run for NC State. They're up by 19. All right, it's 41-22. NC State with a magnificent first half. They're just chopping up Maryland. And now Gilchrist back in the ballgame.
Maryland's got to get a little spurt here to try to get this to about 10. The last 3 minutes, they really got to need a spurt here to get a little momentum going into halftime. What a brilliant performance defensively and offensively by NC State.
Garrison kicks it to Strawberry. And this is not necessarily a team that plays well from behind either. Gilchrist, tough shot, he's fouled. Let's go to Mark Jones. Mark?
Great year, guys, for Julius Hodge. You know, dramatic play a few moments ago on that slam dunk. In fact, he says that he's a communications major with an emphasis on, watch this, theater. He promised that he'd have some theatrics and little drama for us in this upcoming tournament, guys. And remember, a couple of years ago, he let those among press row know that they made some poor decisions in leaving him off of their all-conference team, a guy that learned the game from his older brother Steve at the age of 5 years old. It's been a great mix for him, he says, down on Tobacco Road. Not bad for a guy from Harlem, New York.
Well, I'll tell you one thing. He wants that gold trophy. He wants to win the championship and Duke's run, and he also wants that gold trophy as MVP. He plays like this. He's got a great shot.
And the last 2 years, he has been named first-team All-ACC. Two free throws for Gilchrist. McRae comes back in. Jones will come out.
And if you're Herb Sendick right now, you're a little bit worried that maybe you get a little sloppy right now and you let them creep back into the game. You got that 17-point lead up with 19. Now it's 17.
In the game at NC State 10 days ago, Maryland had a big lead that was wiped out. They came back for that big one-point victory. But North Carolina State is such a good front-running team. They know how to milk the clock so well. And if they're ahead, they make you chase them and set up easy shots.
Yeah, it's very important to get ahead. But even though yesterday they were down 11 at Florida State, showed some guts to come back.
Tonight, Championship Week presented by 7-Up continues on ESPN at 6. Xavier against Dayton in the Atlantic 10 Championship. Then at 8 o'clock, a big one is number 9 UConn goes against the number 6 Pitt Panthers in the Big East Championship. And that game also available on ESPN HD.
Jim Calhoun, future Hall of Famer, doing an amazing job playing without Okafor. Ben Gordon been sensational. Got a chance against Pittsburgh. They're 1-1 with each other.
Mike O'Donnell, number 4 into NC State's lineup, getting a chance to get some minutes. He's a pretty good ball handler.
Hatcher's really gotten a lot better from what we saw earlier.
Hasn't he?
He's starting to blend in. You know, you're playing away from home. He's from Turkey. Takes a while to get into a rhythm, feel comfortable.
It's amazing how fundamentally good the European players are that come over here and play college ball in the States. Shot clock at 5. Melvin. Nice head fake by Watkins. Shot clock at 1. How many times have they done that all year long? They make you play defense for 35 seconds, and then they hit a shot with 1 on the shot clock.
They did a great job right there. Melvin, very unselfish, giving the ball up. That extra pass led to a high percentage shot.
43-24. Gilchrist trying to take it on himself to bring this team back, and they're just not having any luck. Coming up at the half, the 7-Up halftime report. Reese Davis and Digger Phelps will be along. They'll show you how the Dukies rolled again, the Wildcats in the final, and more tickets punched for the big dance.
Well, Dukies did have a turnover in the second half against the athleticism of Georgia Tech.
Remarkable.
Kentucky just keeps marching on. Tubby Smith has done an amazing job since stepping in 98. Will he go back to San Antonio? That's where he won the national title in 98.
Strawberry with a miss. Garrison tries to save it and can't.
Duke's waiting for the winner of this game, trying to get their 6th consecutive ACC championship. 17 in a row, as you said, Mike, and 13 of them have been in double figures.
Every time you see a number like that, it just seems like a misprint. They can't possibly have done that.
They're going to spread the court right here. They really spread that court. Great timing. Pass and go away.
NC State had hit 10 of 11 shots in this streak.
No turnovers either.
Didn't get a crack at that one. Gilchrist with a miss. Fofana fights for the rebound, but it's taken by Melvin to Atsor. Can't hit the shot. Bodies fly. Strawberry had it, then lost it. And a foul.
Atsor finally misses one for them, and it was an easy one, a layup. Herb Sendick from out of Carnegie Mellon. There's a layup right there. A lot of hustle as the ball goes to the deck. See everybody jumping in, scrapping, clawing, hustling. Becomes contagious. That's how
winners. You can see Herb Sendick just holding his breath, waiting to see if all of his players were going to get up. He's already missing 2 of his top 6 with injuries.
He took so much heat early in his career. I mean, the talk shows were going bananas. I really give him a lot of credit. The fact that he had patience, he believed in himself, and most of all, the administrators as well for hanging with him and not allowing people from the outside, because there was a move to get rid of
him. Yes, there was. And Dick, he always seemed to have 1 or 2 key players injured at the wrong time. That's not a coach's fault.
No, and they also had the problem, as we said, with North Carolina and Duke. constantly. Look at this, a couple injured players right there, Cheryl and Jordan. Jordan Collins.
They get it into Hodge against the pressure. A minute and a half to go.
Look at that size. Looks right over the trap because it's about 6'6". Good vision.
Melvin didn't try to penetrate the clock right now. The more important thing for NC State as they lead 19 points approaching halftime.
Hodge is like a point forward that Don Nelson used to describe. Nice ball movement.
Atsur for three. Too strong. Long rebound to Hodge.
Total command. The first half, it's been all North Carolina State. They have dominated.
Going for their 21st win of the season. And Kaner Medley is going to be called for a holding foul away from the ball against Hodge.
They get so much good movement. Take a look at Hodge. He's 6'6", right over the top. He's got the great vision. He can look over the traps. Traps don't bother him. He's a confident kid. I love kids. He's got that all Muhammad Ali team he's going to make for me. He is confident and believes.
Like this is going to be a foul on Fofana, and it is. He was holding Hodge. Now, Dick, if you're Herb Sendek, you go to the locker room and say, just keep doing what you're doing. If you're Gary Williams, what do you possibly say?
Well, he's going to possibly right now talk to them about trapping and playing this game in segments. Digger Phelps and I have often talked about how right now when you're down big like this, you got to play this game in 10-minute segments. So the first 10 minutes, you want to try to outscore them by about 10 to make it to where you got a chance. Hodge, like I said, all Muhammad Ali team. Man, I used to love it when the champ used to tell Sonny Liston, crowd dares the boo, it's over in two. And if you ever call me a bum, I'll knock your sorry butt out in one.
Well, folks, at least he's not talking about his groin, you know. Hodge hits both free throws.
Julius Hodge on that line, really. Dynamite as a team. They shoot 79.9% as a team.
45-24.
Lost to them in their last game at home by one.
Gilchrist kicks it back outside. Three-pointer from McCray. Hammers in and hammers out.
Melvin is such a good player. He gives an inside-outside presence, rebounds, passes the ball well. There he is on the perimeter, the big guy. He brings your big guy away from the basket. They love running those cuts off the post. Part of that offensive system.
And they're so good at spreading the floor. This is Will Roach getting some minutes. Roach lost the ball. The pass ahead to McCray. Got it.
Nice pass. Perfect lead to McCray with the catch.
Melvin looking at the clock. Launches from half court and got pretty close with it. It's 45-26. Gary Williams knows he and his club have a lot of work to do in the last 20. Now the 7-Up halftime report. Reese Davis and Digger Phelps.
Well, Mike, I guess about the best news for Gary Williams here at the end of the first half is with the three-point shot. They cut it to a 7-possession game. Other than that, it has been all North Carolina State, Digger.
Well, State's done a good job ever since they beat Duke at Duke by spreading the floor, especially when they put Hodge in a high post. They penetrate so well, and they make you try to commit. That's when they shoot the threes. If not, they're going to the basket very, very well. Gary Williams got one adjustment the first half into the second half. Come out with fire because you didn't start the game this way. If they get it back to 16 to 12 to 9, 9's that number. There's still time to get it done the first 10 minutes of the second half.
North Carolina State has been in the championship game in each of the last 2 years, and well on its way, it would appear, to trying to make it three. They call him Ismail. The Duke had an answer. We'll talk about the Devils' continued dominance and how they did it to Georgia Tech.
ESPN's exclusive presentation of Championship Week, presented by 7-Up, is brought to you by Jaguar Cars. Jaguar, born to perform.
And that's how we called it in the moment. And in this moment, NC State is ripping Maryland 45-26 as we get ready to start the second half.
Take a look right here. Maryland really had a tough time shooting the basketball. 10 for 24 was Struggle City, but it wasn't a struggle for Hale Julius. He was brilliant in the first half. Also had a little help from a guy by the name of Efterwolf with 16 points.
Nick Kaner-Medley, who has the ball right now, has been held scoreless in this ball game, and he is a key component of Maryland's offense.
Wow, that'll help a little bit.
And a foul.
A little acrobatic shot right there. Try to match that in a game of horse. Maybe that's a sign of some good things to happen for Maryland.
Eftimov just committed his third. And keep in mind that North Carolina State has virtually no depth today because of the injuries to Scooter Sherrill and Jordan Collins.
You know, Garrison goes 0 for 4. Kaner-Medley goes 0 for 2. Pretty tough to win, man, when your starters don't put points on the board. Full court traps. Maryland's done that over the years under Gary Williams.
Gilchrist has double digits for Maryland, the only Terps player in double figures today.
I got Gilchrist now playing Hodge. Hodge got the great size advantage.
Atsor with a runner. Here comes Gilchrist. No look. Smith got it.
They've had two unbelievable shots go in, Mike. Two incredible shots, dramatic shots.
They're going to need more. Atsor ahead. Blocked inside. Smith and Medley combine. Here comes Gilchrist on the run again.
I tell you, Gary's got them all pumped up. They got five in a row. 19 down to 14. I mean, you get down to the 10-minute mark and you get it to 9 or 10. You got yourself a game.
Four pass this time, gets away and out of bounds. Let's check in with Mark Jones. Mark.
Yeah, guys, a couple reports out of the locker room. First of all, with Maryland, asked Gary Williams, coach, what do you do about their high field goal percentage? He said, play hard. I asked, what do you do about them out rebounding you? He said, play hard. What do you do about them out hustling you? He said,
play
we
hard.
We have to play hard. As for North Carolina State, Julius Hodge joined his team in a huddle and said, they're going to make a run at us and feed Soosh. Feed Soosh. Easy to figure out who Soosh is. Keep feeding the monster. They meant Eftimov. He was hot in the first half. Back with more after this.
This is Wendy's headquarters, and they sent me a letter. Dear Mr. Wendy, that's me. Thanks for your kind words. Yes, Wendy's hamburgers are delicious because we make them fresh when you order them. And you're right, our classic double with cheese does rock, especially the combo. But to your self-appointed title of Mr. Wendy, unofficial spokesman, our lawyers insist that you cease and desist from representing us.
That's him.
It's corporate speak for keep up the good work.
Hey, you!
Wendy's classic hamburgers. It's better here.
Hey!
It's the Subaru all-wheel drive away. Now is the time to get a new Subaru Outback with sophisticated monochromatic colors for as little as $235 a month. Or get all-wheel drive ruggedness with up to $1,500 cash back. Or get style and comfort with 1.9% financing for 63 months. Get sophisticated. Get rugged. Get style and comfort. Get the deal of your choice on the Outback of your choice. And get to your Subaru dealer in a hurry because the Subaru all-wheel drive away ends March 31st.
Don't even think of making your picks without watching ESPN on Selection Sunday. Chris, Digger.
That team will play a lot of zone.
Dickie V.
If he gets a moment to shoot the ball, it's automatic.
And the rest of the gang break it all down. You've waited all season.
Hooray, hooray, hooray.
Now, don't miss the most important show before the big dance begins.
I love this action. I'm going for it.
Bracketology, NCAA Men's Selection Special presented by Staples. Sunday at 7 on ESPN.
Maryland's slogan is Fear the Turtle. You would, too, if it was covering your head. It's 45-33. Maryland, in the first minute 19 of the second half, has scored 7 points. They've cut into this deficit, but it's a long way to go.
Well, how would you like the minute halftime with Gary Williams? You think he was fiery? You think that he got his oratory going big time? I mean, he must have been really all fired up. Maybe he called for Scott Van Pelt to help him, who's a passionate Maryland graduate and fan.
Feed to Hodge, wide open.
That'll help after a timeout. He's got a little nervous right there for Herb Sendick. Had a signal for that T.O., baby.
Hodge has 14. I think the reminder in that timeout was, hey, there's a long way to go, and this is not open. That might be a push-off against NC State, and it is.
I'll tell you one thing. Maryland's come out here with a lot of pride here in the second half. They're going to scrap because they reflect that guy right there. As a look at Herb Sendick, he wishes this baby was over now. He knows they're in for a battle.
Bennerman just picked up his third. Eftimov already has three. Garrison, who's been very quiet offensively.
So has McCray, Garrison, and Kidd and Edlin.
McCray tied up. Loose ball and the jam by Smith.
Smith comes up with that loose ball, attacks the basket. They're only down a dozen, my friends.
47-35.
It's that full court press. Gotta get over the top of the trap.
And Atsor foul as they go for the double team. That'll be on Gilchrist.
Take a look at the loose ball. There's Smith picking it up. He's so quick to the basket. Got that quick drive to the goal.
When you're down this far, you need some breaks to have any chance to get back in it.
Maryland really making things happen, though. Defensively, they are active.
They've always been a very good pressing team under Gary Williams. Hodge double team. You hate to see the ball go in the corner because that's where the traps are so effective.
You know, Gary appealed to their sense of pride. Eftimov was on fire in that first half.
Hodge wide open for three.
Hill to Julius, baby. He's on fire as well. What a performance he's putting on here this afternoon.
We have come to praise Julius, not to bury him.
Yes, sir. We're going to praise this Julius.
Smith kicks it out. Garrison with a runner. Got it.
Nice move by Garrison attacking the basket. Wait for Morgan Wooten, one of my favorite people, one of the superstars of all time.
Poor pass in the pick by Gilchrist.
Nice pass.
Smith. Nice pass. The foul.
I'll tell you one thing. These kids from Maryland aren't going to quit, man. There's no quitting them.
If they hit the free throw, they would cut the lead to 10.
I said 10 at the 10-minute mark, my friend. This is 10 in 2 minutes and 55 seconds. That's a look by Gilchrist, a great pass right off the dribble. Took it off the dribble, drove it in. Smith with the conversion.
And the first foul of the game on Marcus Melvin. So Smith goes to the line where he is only a 42% free throw shooter.
And they got another
offensive rebound. I'll tell you, another foul.
There's no doubt that they're the aggressive team here now in the second half. Little desperate, way behind, playing with a lot of pride. It all starts with him. That's why he'll ultimately be a Hall of Famer. There's no doubt about it. Already got a national championship coach. Look at the left right there. Cleared out the lane. Eftimov got knocked right out of the way.
Third foul on Watkins. Ebekwe to the line. Hits the first.
What an amazing 2 minutes and 57 seconds by the Terps.
And still a long way to go.
And remember, not a deep team playing without two guys right now, North Carolina State. Without Collins and without Cheryl.
And this full court press has been effective.
I would get the ball in the hands of Hodge down there. Let him look right over that trap.
McCray picks up the foul, and Dick, they have forced him into the corner at least half the time on this press.
And that's where you want to take him in a trapping situation. You don't want to get yourself in there. I mean, right here. You don't want to get in here. Then beat him to the sideline. That's your friend right there.
Maryland has scored 15 points in 3 minutes. They have cut the lead from 19-9.
I would have loved to hear the halftime talk by Gary Williams. I don't think it was about X's and O's. I don't think at all. It was all about pride, heart, toughness, passion.
NC State trying to spread the court, something they do so well. Hodge backing into the lane. Missed a shot. Kaner Medley with a rebound.
If they can get Kaner Medley going, I'm telling you, he's very capable of getting a little bit streak going offensively.
He loves to shoot those threes out of the corner.
He's matched up with Hodge right now, defending him.
That foul will be on Watkins. That's four on Levi Watkins.
That's big because their bench is so thin right now.
And Herb Sendek doesn't have many options.
Exactly.
Going to get Betterman back in the game.
Can't put in Larry Harris, who was a great player's assistant down in Pittsburgh. Does a fine job as an assistant on that staff.
Watkins will come out. Scooter Sherrill not available.
There's a look at Larry Harris. Outstanding player when he played. They got Coach Hunter on that staff. Does a great job as well.
Offensive foul called against Maryland. I believe, although I have not seen the signal for a foul, just a turnover, I'm assuming.
I tell you, I asked Ed Harden, who's Brian Ryder from out of Greensboro. He's from Greensboro. What about Betterman? He said Betterman was quite a high school player down at Grimsley High School.
Saying one of the Maryland players stepped on the sideline, so that is a turnover.
He's the guy that you want the ball with. They got to start playing a little two-man game with Hodge and Eftemoff.
Eftemoff, great spin. Got away from a Beckway.
Got to get those two guys involved. They're their catalyst. They're the guys that jumped out to that 19-point lead with their performances.
Can Maryland keep up the intensity? It's gotten them close. Smith, runner at the baseline, in and out.
There's that versatility again of Hodge.
Very patient offense, looking for good shots. Melvin dribbles out of a double team. Gilchrist, great interception, one on two, and he scores.
I'll tell you one thing, I think he'd be a great halfback. I think he would be a super halfback in football. Strong, quick, explosive. Gary says, wait a minute, please don't tell our football people to take him.
Gilchrist has 14.
Scrapping and clawing, playing with a lot of heart right now. They're not going to roll over, even though they got a bid locked. Got to make NC State earn the right to play Duke.
There's the lob to Hodge. Catches it very deep. Had no chance to make the basket. Gilchrist will be called for the foul, and Hodge did a great job of creating the contact and went down hard.
He really did. They again can't afford to lose him, that's for sure. Going to watch Hodge got an invert inside. There he is, go down into the post. Talking to Michael Wilbon about him a little bit earlier at halftime about his ability to invert and go to the inside, as you see him right there. Gets fouled. Michael and Tony Kornheiser do a great job with the PTI show.
It's a terrific program.
Yeah, they do a great job. Those two guys have a lot of fun at what they're doing. They enjoy what they're doing. That's half the battle, Mr. Patrick. That's why you're so good. You enjoy what you're doing.
You too, Dick. We can't have more fun than this, can we?
Hey, look at Michael. He's my barber.
You get two coats of wax on that. You do that.
Guy charges me $10 every time I go to see him. Wow, he don't even go for your haircut. I know he doesn't. Northwestern grad, very proud.
Hodge just missed his first free throw. He's 7 out of 8 from the line. Hits the second.
Terrific foul shooting team. Herb Sendek has. Wow.
Great start for the Terps in this second half. They have cut into a 19-point lead big time. Back to Greensboro in a moment.
Tomorrow, guys.
You know what's interesting? Wouldn't that be a great finish for Florida after the things that have happened to them this year?
Amazing. Kid leaves them in the middle of the year. Christian Dreyer, a no-no. Absolutely. A disaster. A kid quits in the middle of the season to go take cash and play in Europe. What a nice start Gary Williams' club has had here in the second half. What a technical foul.
Herb Sendek
for what?
Says what?
We say for what as
they
well.
He said it was a delay of the game.
Oh, yeah. They delayed to come out on that whistle.
Did not come out of the timeout in time, apparently. And that is a technical. Is this big or what? McCray hits two free throws. Duke Edsel explaining to Herb Sendek what happened. Let's see if we can see. Now, I don't know if it was on the young man who came out to wipe off a spot on the floor. But the call is a technical for delay of game, and guess what? It's an 8-point margin.
It's six. The Terps are back big time, and Herb knows it.
This is a stunning comeback by Merrill.
There's a whistle that is signaled, a horn, that you got to get back on the floor after a timeout.
Bennerman short on the jumper. Eftimov, nice recovery. No basket. Eftimov foul.
And then Eftimov with a hole.
Let's go to Mark Jones. He has an explanation on the technical.
When you take a look at the North Carolina State bench, guys, they had been previously warned about guys coming out to wipe the floor. And that's what happened. They came back out. They were whistled for the T, but they had been warned previously once before, so the second one resulted in the T.
Inbounds play, batted away, blocked by Ebekwe.
Oh, wow, was not a time allotment situation. Look at that drive. They're playing like unbelievable. They are so on fire right now.
And look at Gary Williams.
Do you think emotion is important? Do you think intensity? Do you think a passion? Do you think maybe you credit the coach right there and you wonder what coaching is? He got those kids ready to play here in the second half. He appealed to their heart, to their guts. I'm telling you, they're
a different
team.
What could you say to them going in at halftime? Exactly. He hit the right button, whatever it was. 53-49.
Look at the way they're playing. They're playing with a frenzy right now. You take players and let them play with a frenzy, man, they elevate their game. On a scale of five, if they're three-star players, they become five-star players.
You know what? Whether they come back to win this game or not, what they have just done will be something Gary Williams can use in the NCAA tournament.
Oh, wow.
And Ebekwe missed the jam, but Smith got
it. What a turnaround. Herb Sendik's kids are in big, big trouble, baby.
It was 19. Now it's 2.
19, 6 minutes and 27 seconds ago.
Are you kidding?
In 6 minutes, they have outscored them by 17. Now watch this play on the missed dunk. Watch the offensive rebound. Smith just throws it up. Nothing but nylon. What a performance in the last 6 minutes. It all started with that leader right there. Take a look, right? 25-8 run, outscored them by 17.
Dick, they got 26 points in the first half. They have 25 more in the first 6.5 minutes of this half.
And it's all because they're playing with such passion. He appealed to them to that jersey and said, you know what that jersey represents? It represents all the greats that have ever played here. Lenny Baez and Ron Dixon and Tom McMillan and Lenny Elmore and all the greats, man. Get some pride.
Now, how does the Wolfpack respond to this tremendous run being made out?
Well, here's what Julius Hodge got to really show. He's a super. They got an offensive foul on the screen.
On Hodge.
Everything going wrong. Everything going wrong for North Carolina State.
2 on Julius Hodge.
Herb said they cannot believe this turnaround. He runs him down. He grabs him. He grabs him right in front of the referee.
Smith, baseline. Offensive foul on Smith.
First time something's went a little positive way in the second half for NC State. Well, you wanted a tight game, Mr. Patrick, and you got yourself.
Well, we
one.
Got it. I didn't think it'd happen this way. I thought it would be tight the entire time. But Maryland was just getting blown out of the building.
Jacket
and Herb
off.
Sendik, the jacket's gone. Is the tie next? Atzor, nice head fake to get the defender up in the air. Then he drives. Kicks it to Hodge.
Got
to
get up the ball for a three.
Hodge too strong. Smith with a rebound. Maryland can tie with a 2. They can take the lead with a 3.
They are the attacker. They are the aggressive team here.
Garrison, who has done all nothing all the entire game, ties it with a jumper.
Incredible. Everybody's in it. It's become contagious. They're all feeling it.
3-on-2. Atzor foul by Strawberry.
I don't think they know what's hit them. You're looking at the NC State players, the way they're walking into a huddle, they're shocked. They are absolutely stunned.
Aren't you?
Yeah, I am. I'm stunned. I have been around the game for a lot of years. I didn't expect this quick turnaround.
I mean, we've seen big comebacks. We've seen great comebacks, yeah. But this is unbelievable.
In 7 minutes, especially the way they played in that first half, NC State.
From down 19 to even. Hodge, double team, lost it. Got it back on the floor, calls a timeout. Every pass, every dribble contested by Maryland. And the NC State fans don't know what to think right now.
And right now, if you're North Carolina State, here's where a coach has got to be poised and not get the kids to panic. You got to simply say, we're even now. It's a 12-minute basketball game.
And waiting in the wings, the Blue Devils of Duke, who advance to yet another conference championship game with a brilliant second half performance. Wiping out Georgia Tech.
They didn't have one turnover in that second half. Chris Duhon was their leader, as he's been all year long, as they now journey for the sixth consecutive of two assistant coaches, Chris Collins on the left and Wojciechowski. They look like they could play for a CYO team. 17 and unders.
12:37 to go in the game. Maryland down by 19. Now they have tied it. Melvin for three, too strong. Benjamin, great leaping rebound, and the follow.
What a terrific offensive rebound by Benjamin. Here's a kid we talked about in the first half, was getting limited minutes until Scooter Sherrill was injured. 16 and 17 in those last 2 games.
And that was a huge play there. The momentum was all for the Terps.
They need a defensive stop right here, North Carolina. See, they're getting a little more scrappy now.
Gilchrist from a mile outside.
Confidence has gone the way of Maryland. The momentum has gone the way of Maryland.
And the Terps have taken the lead for the first time in the game, down 19 at the half. They have outscored NC State by 20. Do you believe this? Eftemont, tough turnaround shot.
Gilchrist is really determined, and you can see the determination in every bounce.
McCray wheels into the lane.
Right now, if I'm NC State, I want to work the ball and get Eftemont the shot from the wing. He is so effective in that first half, shooting the three.
What happens if you're a North Carolina State fan? You went out at halftime, there's long lines at the concession stand, and you were 5 minutes late getting back.
Or maybe you left, you thought it was a blowout.
Then you turn on the radio and
That'll help.
Big three.
Make some threes will help, and they do that really well.
Marcus Melvin, second team, all ACC. He's got a great stroke from outside. NC State has the lead back. And the Wolfpack's at 9 out of 15 from long range.
A lot of times when you exhaust yourself to get back like this, you run out of the tank that's empty.
Gilchrist, pull-up jumper for three.
He made four big threes last night in that game over Wake Forest.
John Gilchrist has 22 points.
I tell you, Gary Williams is the kind of guy I can play for, man. I really can. He doesn't quit. He fights. He scraps every possession.
Atsor steps out of bounds, turns it over to the Terps. And look how calm Gary Williams is right now. 22 points for Gilchrist, 15 in this half, and Maryland has the lead.
Going to see how they take them into a trapping area. Maryland likes to trap, especially if you go along that sideline. They're going to go into a hard trap right here. Double up, freeze it. See, there's the double up on the ball. Now he's trying to look over the top. Very difficult. Now Hodge is screaming for the ball. He's frustrated. Look, he wants the ball, but he's got to step to the ball. He's running away from it. Makes it deep difficult for his teammate to find him.
Last game of the regular season, Maryland was down 11 against Virginia. Came from behind to win. They have been down many as 20 in this one.
And it was a 20 where they were being humiliated.
Ebekwe called for an offensive foul trying to get position inside.
Look at the last 10 minutes. Look at this run right here. 33-13, shooting 13-18. And what a performance by the sophomore Gilquist.
Ebekwe had the steal, couldn't hold it.
I mean, I cannot sing the praises of what Gary Williams did at halftime to rile up these kids, to get them out here in a frenzy.
And it they obviously listen.
It starts with leadership. They better listen or they're not going to get no PT.
Inbound to Atsur as we approach the 10-minute mark in this game. NC State has to be shell-shocked.
Exactly. I was just going to say that, Mike. They got to forget about that and just start playing again and realize they're in a battle. Can't feel sorry for yourself. Can't get a little down and feel sorry. People aren't going to give you sympathy. And certainly Maryland's not going to give them any sympathy. Nice backdoor cut.
Atsur couldn't handle a bounce pass. Then he's left all for three and buries it.
Atsur with the big three. Loose ball. That's their game, making threes, making free throws.
Atsur has made three threes in this game. NC State has the lead again. Smith, a little turnaround and hits it. We're tied at 61.
Was not challenged at all in that possession as that full court pressure.
Foul will be on Gilchrist, his third.
Very important to step to that ball.
Tomorrow, an ABC NBA doubleheader starting at 12:30 Eastern. First, the 76ers and the Pistons. Then, Tim Duncan and San Antonio Spurs against the Sacramento Kings. Some of you will see the Knicks and the Bucks in regional action. That's tomorrow on ABC starting at 12:30 Eastern. ABC, home of the NBA Finals.
That's Chris Ford coaching against Larry Brown. Chris Ford owes me a lot. I'll tell you that, Mike. I traded him for Earl Tatum. And when he went to Boston, he won national world titles. Where's my ring? I mean, I made him a star by shipping him to Boston.
A rare miss from the free throw line for North Carolina State. Maryland with a chance to regain the lead, and Gilchrist, who has been terrific, guarded by Hodge.
Look at Hodge taking on a challenge now. He wants to challenge Gilchrist. He's got sides on him.
Strawberry, great drive, couldn't finish. Atsur ahead of the pack. And that's a walk on Atsur.
He said, I didn't lift my pivot foot, but he did. He dragged it. You know what I like about Hodge? He knows right now that Gilchrist is on fire, and he is asking for the right to play Gilchrist. He wants to challenge him. He said, look at him. Come on. Play me, big fella. Here it is. Game within the game, they call it. Look at him talking jive. He talked out on the streets out of New York, man, down at the Rucker.
He and Pickett went at it for 40 minutes last night. There was not a moment of silence between those two. Fadeaway jumper, no good, but the foul on Eftimov. That will be four on Ilian Eftimov.
Eftimov so valuable to this club, and shorthand, you know, talking that jive stuff and all that is fine if you do it in good sportsmanlike conduct. But if you're going to do it, you're a little carried away, unsportsmanlike, there's no place for it, man, no place. Even though Michael Jordan did some talking.
Smith at the line. Got it. Jamar Smith. 18 points, 11 of them in this half. Maryland back on top.
Also, the kid from French Lick, Indiana could talk it as well. They also can back it up. Back it up.
Well, if you talk the talk, you have to walk the walk.
Larry Bird. In fact, I think this year we might see a team in a Final Four other than a mega conference team for the first time since 79 with Indiana State, and Penn was there as well.
Gilchrist will get a breather at the 8:50 mark. You might want to write this down. It's a two-point lead for the Terps when Gilchrist goes to the bench. Tough getting the ball inbounds. They get it to Hodge. Two on one. Hodge will take himself over Smith, and Smith gets the foul.
Great job by Hodge to create the foul opportunity in that situation.
You know, they're taking Gilchrist out for a rest. What happens now on a foul? The clock doesn't run, and Gilchrist still gets the breather.
Yeah, it's a little breather right here. I tell you, they had to give him a breather. He was exhausted. He poured his heart out there in the first 10 minutes.
Julius Hodge hits the free throw. 20 points for the All-ACC performer. Eftimov on the bench with his fourth foul, and Hodge hits them both. We're tied again.
That's been a consistent area for NC State all year, making free throws.
Kaner Medley had the three and passed on it.
Remember, people, the winner gets Duke. Duke trying to go for a sixth consecutive ACC championship.
Bennerman picks up his fourth foul. Terrible foul problem for Herb Sendek and North Carolina State.
And again, like you said earlier, it's really compounded because of their bench depth. They don't have any at all without Sherrill or without Collins.
Right now, Eftimoff with four, Watkins with four, Bennerman with four, and Kaner Medley misses the free throw. It's been the bane of Maryland's existence all year.
He's also been struggling here. This has not been a Kaner Medley kind of game. Trying to spread the court here. Invert again. There he goes. Hodge to the inside. Comes off a down screen. He got the ball in his hands. Good things happen when he has it.
Kaner Medley, who averages 13 points a game, has been held scoreless in this one.
I'd get it back to Hodge, man. I'd get Hodge or Melvin involved.
5 seconds. Melvin trying to drive down the lane and score.
Hodge or Melvin. Get the two of them involved right now.
McCray dribbles it off his foot right to Kaner Medley.
Goes down to the last 3 minutes. The edge certainly goes to North Carolina State on a free throw line.
Smith, tough bounce pass across the lane, knocked out of bounds, out to the Terps with 7:56 to go in a wild one. North Carolina State up by 19 at the half. Melvin's doing his part. Kaner Medley has been nearly shut out.
Go, guys.
All right, thanks, guys. 7:56 to go in this one. And it has been an unbelievable ball game. North Carolina State was up by 19 at the half. Right now, they're up by two. Maryland is actually led. And Gilchrist, who was only out of the game 54 seconds in clock time, actually had a 4.5-minute rest on the Maryland bench. Loses this one, saved by Kaner Medley.
They got to get Medley some shots. Kaner Medley.
Shot clock down to two, and Gilchrist hits a miracle.
I'll tell you, what a second half he has had. He's been absolutely brilliant. He was this way last night against Wake Forest.
John Gilchrist with 25 points.
Steal.
Strawberry.
Strawberry with the steal. Herb Sendek really cannot believe what he's watching.
He's got to be thinking, I have never seen anything like this in my life. Let's check in with Mark Jones.
Hey, guys, I'm standing here with the Gilchrist crew with John Jr., John III, doing a job right now for Maryland. Your son plays with incredible intensity.
Thank you. Yes, he does. He plays with a lot of heart, a lot of fire, just wants to win.
Has it been problematic at times with him and his coach and their relationship?
Well, you know, both guys want to win real, real bad. And one guy with the coach wants him to do well, and he wants to do well. But sometimes you just try a little too hard and make little mistakes. Just growing pains.
Have you seen him play like this before? And where does he get this trait from?
Well, it goes way back. I mean, just loving the game. Just really loving the game.
All right, Mom's a little shy, guys. But Loretta is right here beside me. And Mama, if he gets his aggressiveness from Dad, what's the trait he gets from you, dominant trait?
His wonderful smile.
We've seen more of a scowl from him today than anything else.
Oh, yeah. It's been wonderful. It's been great.
Oh, guys, it's a loud section here, and the volume keeps getting pumped up. Back to you.
All right, thanks, Mark. Julius Hodge with 23. Great feed inside to Smith, and it's 70-67. John Gilchrist has been magnificent.
He really has, and Mom and Dad certainly proud wearing that number 11. He's got a winner's mentality. Whenever you talk to him, they go to a little zone right now. I'm back to man-to-man. Smith's had his way with NC State in the previous two games, averaged 19.5 against him.
Smith picks up a foul, trying to deny Melvin position.
It's just been an incredible performance, all keyed by Gary Williams and then his point guard, Gilchrist, executing what he wanted on that floor. Hey, we got a little break in the action, and I know you feel the same way I do. We want to send our best to a colleague, to a real, real friend, a guy I love. He's been great to me in my 25 years. Steve Anderson, his dad, certainly an outstanding writer with the New York Times. Steve had heart surgery yesterday. I got a message from his wife today. Spoke to her before the surgery, and all we can simply say, Steve, we're all praying for you. We all love you. And lots of luck, man. You're going to be fine. Keep the faith.
I have known people who have been through the exact same surgery, and they came out of it just in wonderful shape. Steve, we will be thinking all the best for you.
He and his wife, Roseanne, a great couple.
NC State basketball, 6:35 to go in the game. Maryland up by two. Melvin for three. Hodge kept it alive, then lost it. McCray, no look, bounce pass. Smith fouled before the shot.
Maryland really attacking with every possession, whether it be in transition, whether it be in a half-court game, whether it be with their defense. It's attack, attack, attack. He's chewing that gum, man. Gary Williams has got to feel proud, but knowing this guy, he wants no moral victory. He doesn't want to hear about great effort.
Smith, who has 14 points in this half, 21 for the game, has actually hit 3 out of 4 free throws. Certainly not Maryland's strong suit and not his. He is a 42% free throw shooter on the year. He has looked like a 90% free throw shooter in this one.
Gary working that sideline, an avid golfer during the offseason. He goes on a journey sometimes with guys like Dave Gavitt, the brilliant architect of the Big East, and also with guys like Jimmy Boeheim. They go to Europe and play some golf. Take a look right here, baby. The Terps. Who would have thought it? Down 19.
Nobody. Eftem off.
They can't get Eftem off any looks from the three.
Melvin goes down the lane. They bail him out. He was out of control with the foul. And it will be on Nick Kaner-Medley. Only his second.
Kurt would like to see Eftemoff being able to spot up and get some looks at that three because he was so effective shooting early.
Eftemoff, 17 points in the ballgame. Hodge, the leading scorer for NC State with 23. But Eftemoff has been held to only 2 points in this entire half. Melvin free throw line hits this one. NC State, the leading free throw shooting team in the country. They would set an ACC record at their present pace of 79-9. Today they've hit 15 out of 90.
And it's really great when you got that as part of you, as a weapon. It's really a great asset to possess. Guys that can step up and make free throws for you. 16 out of 20 here today.
2-point game again. 6 minutes left in Greensboro.
Will it be North Carolina State and Duke? Will it be Maryland and Duke? Take a look. You're 17 for 23. 18.
And Gilchrist could make it from the parking lot right now.
18 for 24. He's also, if he gets into that championship game, have a great shot for the MVP will be Gilchrist.
A career-high 28 points for John Gilchrist. He has been magnificent in this unbelievable comeback.
That basket's like an ocean for him. See how they attack Eftemoff so he doesn't get a look at the three.
Tipped away by Smith.
He had all kinds of open looks in that first half because they didn't play with a frenzy like they're playing now. Just shows you young kids out there. You play hard, you play with intensity, you play with feeling. A lot of good things can happen.
Gary may have told him he'd be the only one on the plane home if this didn't happen.
Got a Beckway challenge.
Hodge, tough runner.
James Hodge doing all he can to keep him in the game. Down
Hodge
three.
Has 25. Hodge and Gilchrist really putting on a show.
Hodge matching up on him, trying to check him right now.
But Beckway, nice move to get away from Eftemoff, and then he bricked the shot. Jones with a follow.
That's just that hustling him right there, coming up with that loose ball on a glass.
Melvin. That ball was kicked. They'll get a fresh 35 on the shot clock. But Maryland is now up by 5. That is a 24-point turnaround in 15 minutes.
Different basketball team. It's all with the mental attitude. That's what it really came about. Not about just executing. It's a mental attitude.
You know, Dick, I wouldn't believe this if I hadn't seen it with my own eyes.
I know. I feel the same way. They played such a perfect first half when you looked at NC State.
Eftemoff, tough shot, won't go.
Tries to go with a little left-handed hook shot.
Gilchrist has taken 8 shots in this half. He's made them all.
He's been the man. He'll be the big man on campus.
Eftemoff got the rebound.
Hodge's got to want the ball and attack the basket.
NC State needs to execute its offense right now. They're down by 5.
Really matching up on Eftemoff to take away any look at the three.
Melvin, wow. What a tough shot. He banked
second in. That was a big time move right there by Mr. Melvin. That's why he made the second team all ACC.
13 points for Marcus Melvin, a 3-point game.
They need a defensive stop. A little matchup here. Hodge up on top of the zone.
Maryland riding an adrenaline high. McCray, bounce pass, Gilchrist.
Just get the ball to Gilchrist and something good's gonna happen. What a game he's having. Mom and dad cheer.
30 points for John Gilchrist. 23 in the second half. Look at the totals from Gilchrist and Hodge.
Now, Hodge going inside, trying to post. There it
got
is.
It to him.
Said, anything you can do, I can do better. I can use either hand, uses the left hand, inverts, goes down to the post. What a great second half by Maryland.
Dick, what a ball game. 79-76. Everybody in this building thought it was over except Gary Williams and his Terps.
It's life in the ACC.
That one hit the underside of the rim. Smith got too deep.
He's got out to Watkins. Nice rebound by
O'Donnell with a rebound, or Atchor with a rebound, the miss. And Gilchrist indignantly snatches the ball.
Look at his look on his face. He's like, this is my ball, this is my
That's
game,
right.
And I am the boss.
And he has been.
This is my court right now. He said, this is my game and my court. Look at that pass.
Smith walk.
Great look by Gilchrist. You could just see, hates to make a mistake. You could see it on his face.
What a performance by the Terps. Only 2:29 to go in the semifinal.
And Mike, what a great finish in the Big Ten. Michigan State and Wisconsin, 2-point game. Maurice Ager for the tie. And it would not go. And for the first time, Wisconsin is going to the Big Ten final. They will take on Illinois. 68-66 the final. The Atlantic 10 final about to get underway. We'll keep you up to date on that and back to the ACC after the break.
If you were with us in the first half and went out maybe to enjoy the nice weather where you are, surprise, it's 79-76 Maryland, down by 19 at the half. NC State, on an average, gives up 64 points a game. Maryland has scored 53 in the second half alone.
As one key word here, tempo of the game. As you look at the field goal percentage here in the second half, to the Brick City early, it has been the tempo of the game. It's certainly been the way Maryland wanted it. A fast-paced, frenzied game in the second half, and that has played right into their hands.
Come on.
Nice move. Great move to the basket. Good spin in the lane. Eftemore taking it to the goal. Let's see what they got for 2 minutes, baby.
79-78. Gilchrist handling the ball as much as he can. He has 30.
Hodge trying to deny him the ball, trying to keep it away from him. Trying to deny him. Right now, he's got to get him defensively.
Would be the only way to stop him in this half.
He has been on fire, this guy with the rock in his hands.
Shot clock at 11. It's up to McCray now. He'll take the three.
That's
Hodge with a rebound. Now State with a chance to regain the lead.
Not the shot they really wanted in that offensive set. Right now, you're a Maryland fan. You don't want to see this effort wasted with a great comeback talk. You want that W. Here comes the patience. And remember, great free throw shooting team. Oh, you got to step and catch that ball.
Melvin got it blocked from behind. Great defense by Strawberry.
He went for the ball lackadaisically. I don't think he thought anybody was there. You got to step with authority to catch that ball.
Terps by one. 1:02 left for the run to beat Duke.
Right now, I'd keep the ball out of the hands of number 11 right here. Whether he's shooting or whether he's passing, he's making good things happen. Hodge checking him with his size.
9 on the shot clock. Gilchrist trying to get inside. Now it's McCray. Down the lane. Got it.
What a nice drive. Big opening. Right in the gap of the defense. Attack the gap with his athleticism.
Maryland's made one critical shot after another. And now Hodge.
One possession game.
Tries to get inside. Draws the foul.
Julius Hodge wants that gold trophy. He's got to get to that final game.
And that's 5 on DJ Strawberry, the best defender that Maryland has.
I mean, you got to salute the kids from out of Maryland, from College Park. What an incredible effort here in the second half. DJ playing hard on the defensive end. There he is, known as a defensive player.
And that's against the 6'8 Melvin.
Melvin was a little lackadaisical stepping to that basketball. Well, who will it be, buddy? Will it be Duke and Maryland? Will it be Duke and NC State?
The only answer I have, it'll be Duke. I know they already won. I'm afraid to make a prediction about this one.
What a future. When you think about the youth on his basketball team for Maryland, and the great thing is they'll all be back because none of them are ready for that next level.
When Gary said at the beginning of the year, you know, we've got some talent, I think next year certainly will be a lot better, maybe by the end of this year. Well, it's the end of this year, and they're a lot better.
Well, the only negative is the other teams are going to be better. Duke will be better, certainly. North Carolina is going to be better. Wake Forest with Paul and company coming back. It's going to be an incredible year. Georgia Tech. What else is different in the life of the ACC?
Now, I think they're saying Nick Caner-Medley cannot come in as a substitute because they send him to the scorer's table. No time went off the clock. Gary Williams is arguing his case.
He's not going to win it, though. He's not going to win the argument.
So Garrison's got to come back in the game, and Caner-Medley will not be allowed to come in. If no time goes off the clock, you cannot substitute.
And not a bad decision for Gary, because he's got a better rebound around the floor.
Hodge missed the first free throw.
82% all year.
On a team that doesn't miss, Hodge is the player who doesn't miss.
Especially late in the game, if you were to chart him.
27 points, 12 out of 14 from the line. This is critical to make it a two-point game.
Got to go to full court pressure and try a steal or foul quickly. Maryland really not a good free throw shooting team, as you pointed out, Mike.
Maryland takes the timeout. They're up by two. This is what has happened.
Critical.
In this ball game. In the first half, Maryland couldn't throw it in the ocean if they were standing 5 feet away on the beach.
It was Brick City. Look at them hanging their head.
In the second half, they couldn't miss.
It was absolutely nothing but nylon from every which way and every angle. Everything was going down. Somebody called the fire chief. They're burning down the nets.
Particularly Gilchrist, who has been brilliant in this game. A career high 30 points. He has also kicked in 7 assists.
Also was brilliant last night against Wake Forest.
Yes, he was.
Inbounding the ball is always a little bit of an interesting thing. They got 5 against 4. They're playing with a safety now. They're not bothering a guy in the baseline.
And if you don't get the ball right away, you've got a foul and hope that the Terps will continue their poor track record of free throw.
Step the guy out of bounds.
Caner-Medley, Levi Watkins will commit the foul. And for Watkins, that's 5. He's gone.
Had to commit that foul out here. We got a 1-possession game right now.
Eftimoff will come back in. Watkins fouls out of the ball game. And Herb Sendek virtually has no bench at this point.
Well, Eftimoff coming in gives him that 3-point threat.
Caner-Medley, 63% free throw shooter.
A struggle here this afternoon shooting the basketball.
First trip to the line in this game, gets the roll. It's still a 1-possession game. If he hits this, it's a 2-possession game.
He has had a tough time scoring here this afternoon. That's his first point. Would you believe that? That's Caner-Medley's first point in the afternoon.
And if you had said if Caner-Medley doesn't score till 27 seconds left to go in the game, where would Maryland be? Beaten, you would assume.
And they have 83 points, and he's got a deuce. But nothing bigger than those two he just converted there.
Maryland has hit 80% at the line today. This is a team that shoots 61.4% on the year. They are dead last in the ACC.
Well, I guess that old story right about now, you throw all those stats out and you just play.
Well, apparently, because Maryland has just had a brilliant second half of this game. If you joined us late, the Terps and the Wolfpack playing for the right to meet Duke for a championship tomorrow. Maryland was down 19 at the half. They were actually down 21 earlier in the first half, and now they lead by 4.
How good has this conference been? Think about it. Maryland's in 6th place in this conference. 6th place. The number 2 team is right now in big trouble, North Carolina State. all because of the amazing job he did at halftime.
It's got to be one of Gary Williams' most proud moments in coaching.
Oh, I got to believe that.
No matter what happens in the last 25 seconds.
Got to score quickly. Got to get a quick deuce. Just attack. You don't need to kill a lot of time.
Wasting a lot of time off the clock. And they don't have it.
A lot of time off the clock.
Melvin has to take a long three. Can't hit it. Eftimov. Back to Melvin. We're down to 7 seconds.
It's over. It's over. It's going to be celebration time in College Park.
Maryland has run off one of the greatest comebacks in the history of ACC basketball.
An amazing comeback because of how poorly they played in the first half and how dominant NC State is. Oh, and they're celebrating down at Bentley's on the campus now at College Park.
You can't get into the Green Turtle.
Eftimov couldn't get any opportunities to shoot a three in the second half.
And they're calling NC State back out of their huddle. Eftimov has fouled out of the ballgame, and Kaner Medley will go back to the line to ice it. Right now it's a 4-point lead.
I guess, Coach, as they simply say, Coach Patrick, that's why you play 40 minutes.
That's why Yogi said it's never over till it's over.
Did Yogi say that?
Yes, he did.
Yogi.
Yogi would have loved this one.
Yes, sir.
Maryland has outscored North Carolina State 58-34 in the second half.
Look at the smiles. Sadness right there, and a lot of smiles on the Terp fans.
And John Gilchrist has had the game of his life.
You wonder how a loss like this could affect North Carolina State psychologically.
Julius Hodge hits one at the buzzer, a meaningless shot. Herb Sendek gives Gary Williams a handshake. Gary Williams has just pulled off something akin to a miracle.
He really got his kids ready to play here in the second half. He went in at halftime, would not believe that it was over, and he really convinced them to play with passion and play with enthusiasm and energy.
John Gilchrist played the perfect game in the second half. 9 for 9 from the floor. He finished with 30 points and 7 assists in the ball game. So Maryland will face Duke tomorrow at 1 for the Atlantic Coast Conference Championship. Let's go to Mark Jones.
Hey, guys, I'm with Gary Williams, Coach. We have to know, what'd you say to your team at halftime to get them all geeked up?
I wish I remembered. We talked about our tradition, you know, for the last 10 years, how we played in big games. And, you know, it made some sense, I guess. But it's always the players. Whenever anything turns around like that, it's always the players.
Eftimov was very quiet after a big first half. What was different in dealing with him?
He's really good. He had a great first half. The only thing we tried to do, we had more healthy bodies than they did. We just tried to go hard on every play in the second half and try to wear them down.
There have been times in the last 2 years where you've kind of butted heads with your point guard, but it's a great marriage, isn't it, especially today?
Oh, that's all part of the learning process. I butted heads with Steve Blake, Steve Francis. You know, we've all had our moments, but those guys can really play.
What did Gilchrist's leadership and point production mean today to the team?
Well, he came out the second half with a determination that we weren't going to get beat by 20. I don't think too many of us were thinking about the win right away. We were thinking about getting back in the game. And, you know, I tried to tell him that if we could get it to 10 with about 10 minutes left, then we had a chance to win.
Coach, thanks for joining us. Good luck tomorrow against Duke.
Thank you very much.
Back to you, Mike.
All right, thanks very much. The final score, 85-82. This has been a presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports. For Dick Vitale and Mark Jones and our entire ESPN crew, hope you've enjoyed watching this one. We talked about making history. This one did. For more, log on to ESPN.com. Now back to Reese Davis in the studio.
All right, Mike, Digger Phelps here. And Digger, we talked about, and Gary Williams echoed the comment, if they could get it to 10, Nobody knew they were going to get it to 10 in about 4 minutes, though.
Well, they came out early in that second half. They really had the defensive intensity, and that's how it started, because they put more pressure on the ball, and they didn't worry about State shooting from the perimeter. What they did a better job, though, Maryland, was getting defensive rebounds and getting that fast break going so that John Gilchrist could get his game offensively. And that was the difference to start that second half. And once they cracked it to 15 to 10, and then when they got it on the double figures, NC State never recovered.
All right, so after the monumental comeback, now Maryland advances to the championship game, and they'll try to stop this 17-game reign of terror that Duke has in the ACC tournament. Duke took care of Georgia Tech 85-71. Sheldon Williams, another huge game. Time now to go out to the Atlantic 10 championship games.
Are on a roll. The youngest team in the ACC is playing more like a seasoned squad in the conference tournament. The Maryland Terrapins, who in the last week have gone from a bubble team in trouble of not making the big dance to a contender to take home the ACC hardware for the first time in 20 years. Three straight wins, trying to make it four in a row today in their semifinal matchup with NC State, the same team that started the Terps' current win streak. Time for the First Mariner Bank Terps game summary. There is the man, Gary Williams, very focused, hoping to get into tomorrow's final. First half, Akeni Ubekwe, the steal. He's all alone for the jam coming right at you. Terps down five, and then it gets ugly. Eleni of Eftimov just blowing up for three. Money, he's got it all over the floor, picking up trash, going back outside. He's got another three here. The guy on fire, Eftimov, with a very difficult name, was perfect from the field. 4 for 4 from beyond the arc. 15 in the first half, he was money. And if that wasn't enough, Julius Hodge adds his flavor. Absolutely destroying Nick Cantor-Medley and Mike Jones on his way to the rack. That deserves another look. Strong stuff from Hodge. Pack up 19 at the half. But it was the tale of two halves. Second half, John Gilchrist to Jamar Smith. And one, Terps within 11. Gilchrist then decides to do it himself. Going to take a baseline for the deuce. And the rally is on. Terps down just six. And Gilchrist is feeling it. I said feeling it. Beyond the arc deep. Nails it. Terps, first lead of the game, 56-55. Johnny on the spot does it again. When you're hot, hey, you catch all the breaks. More proof of that. Gilchrist is going to go to the bank, and he's going to get it for another three. 66-65 Terps. 23 points for Johnny in the second half. Perfect from the floor. Then off the inbounds pass, hey, DJ Strawberry. Robin folks gets the steal and the lay-in. The Terps' biggest lead of the game, 68-65. Under a minute to go, it's Chris McCray working the lane, hits the lay-in. And the Terps come from 21 points down and knock off the Pack, 85-82 the final. The Terps outscoring NC State in the second half by 57-34. Gilchrist with a career-high 30 points. Look at his numbers, 11 of 13. 5 of 7 from the three-point line, and the Terps are headed to the ACC Finals tomorrow at 1. Our Chick Hernandez is in Greensboro with post-game reaction.
As you can imagine, it is a wild scene here in Greensboro. The Maryland Terrapins down 19 at halftime, come back to beat the NC State Wolfpack, tying the greatest comeback in ACC tournament history with 23 second-half points from John Gilchrist.
I've never been a part of a comeback like this, you know, maybe since maybe AAU.
I never experienced anything like this, especially on this level.
Did you think we can do this?
Yeah, I mean, you know, I had a little bit of doubt in my mind going in there, but, you know, as we came out and just fought at the beginning, you know, and cut it down to 10, you know, anytime you can get it to 10 quick, you know, you have a chance.
They cut the lead by 10 in the first 3 minutes. By the time 7 minutes and 10 seconds had gone by, so had the Wolfpack's 19-point bulge. Travis Garrison's 2 points gave the Terps a 1-point lead. So just what exactly did the head coach tell his team at halftime?
We talked tradition about how many great players have played with the Maryland uniform on. Going back to Gene Shue, I mentioned him. Went right through Elmore, McMillan, all those guys. Talked about Steve Francis, Steve Blake, Juan, Lonnie.
He couldn't even scream. You know, he was just like, you know, who are we to disrespect this program? You know, we're really hurting ourselves, you know, not to take advantage of this opportunity and seize the moment and just come out here and let a team play harder than us. You know, no matter what, shots may not fall. They may hit all their shots. You know, we may make mistakes, but today you can't substitute that for playing hard.
We came in here, coach said we pressing, we running around, don't worry about no fouls, just run around.
just try to get the ball, and that's what everybody did. And we just thankful.
The last two games we played proved that we're a good team as long as we're playing hard. So we just got to go out tomorrow and leave it on the floor.
Take a three, and the ball doesn't even bounce off the rim. It just dies. That's when you know what you're doing.
Definitely, definitely. I mean, the ball died on the rim and just fell in. You know, we played games against other teams where that happened, you know. So, I mean, it was only fate that eventually it was going to happen for us one time.
You know, now it shows, you know, and this is one of those things that we're going to be able to talk about in the future if it ever happens again. Hopefully it doesn't, but if it does, you know, remember when, you know. And there's no more of a pressure situation than this, and if we can do it in this situation, we can do it in any situation.
And the situation is this. Gary Williams can recall history one more time. It was exactly 20 years ago that the Maryland Terrapins won their last ACC tournament title. Tomorrow, they get Duke. With the Terps in Greensboro, Chick Hernandez, Comcast Sportsnet.
All right, thanks, Chick. Looking good. Well, this will be the Terps' ninth trip to the ACC final. They are 2-6 so far in title games. Their wins coming in 1984 against the Blue Devils and in 1958 against the Tar Heels. Overall, the Terps are 1-2 against Duke in the ACC title game. Well,